Welcome to another installment of Local TV Tutor. Today I'm going to take you guys through I'm going to continue to show you guys how to configure your standby database. I'm going to be more focused now on the standby database itself. So the first thing that I'll do is I already have my command prompt open. I'm just going to cd to my local home. And see to my local home. Paste. And I'm gonna go to the directory called database. And when I'm in database, I'm gonna run the dig command to see what's in my database. As you guys can see, I have an init file for all of my databases, init file and an SP file. For all my database. So what I have to do is I have to create an init file for the new service that I created last time, which is OCO2_DG. So what I'll do is what I would recommend is if you have a 32-bit version of Windows, you can run the edit command. It's gonna open a Notepad, like a text editor for you, which is Notepad. Which is Notepad. Actually, hold on. Let me make sure I have this right. So if you have the 32-bit version, you hit edit. It's gonna open a text editor where you can put the content of your file. But if you have a 64-bit version like I do, what I would recommend is to use the command start Notepad. And then I'm going to create the file init.oco2_dg.org. And then that's going to start, that's going to create a Notepad. That's going to open up Notepad as my text editor. So the only parameter that I need for now is db_names equals OOCL1, which is the primary database for my, the standby database will be copying is the content from. So what I'll do is I will save this file, close it, and then now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go to so this is the window that I was using for my previous standby database. So what I do now is I will exit, and then I will set my OCO SID OCO_ SID equals to OCL2_DG. And then what I'm going to do now is I am going to SQL plus. Let me make sure I have my view. Okay, let's do this. Have safety here. Okay. So I'm connected to an added instance, as you guys can see. So what I need to do next is I have a P file. And what I want to do is I want to crystallize all of the queries that I'm gonna run now into my system. So I need to basically make sure that I do create an SP file. As you guys can see, I don't have an SP file yet. So what the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna issue a command, create SP file from P file. I come to this page and run the dir command, as you guys can see, I have an SP file now, SP file OOCL_DG. So what I do now is I will issue a command, start up my mount. And remember, the only parameter that I have my file is db_name, which is the only thing that you need for now in order to get the instance started. And what I would do while this is taking place, I am going to show you guys what The content is for my a typical standby database. So I already have, I'm gonna show you guys this one. So pretty much, if you guys can see, like, I have a lot of what you call it, like, everything I have in the standby database, a lot of these parameters are exactly what I have in my in the primary database. The only difference is I have added the db underscore file underscore name underscore convert, and that's I've done this because I want to standardize basically the communication from the primary database to the standby database. So I need to open up this. I'm gonna open up this this right here, and then I'll be making the changes to my live standby database based on these parameters for you guys, so you guys can see what I'm exactly referring to. So let me minimize this. Okay. So the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna issue the command auth system set. Log underscore archive underscore dest underscore one equals location equals, remember I have a different location for my standby database for the archive logs, so what I'll do is this is my location for the archive logs. I will copy this, come to my window, valid underscore 4 equals all underscore log files, comma, all underscore rows, close paren, db underscore unique underscore name equals RCL. RCL2 underscore DG, close it, simplification, scope equals SP file. There you go. That's the first change I'm gonna make to my standby database. The next one is gonna be author system set DB underscore unique underscore name equals RCL2 underscore DG scope equals SP file. Okay. And if you guys can remember, I already have, I have these two parameters that would seem to be the same thing, but they're actually not. DB name is the parameter for the primary database, and DB underscore unique name is the name for the standby database. I'm going to issue a command. This is a important command. I'm going to issue a command also system set log underscore archive underscore format equals. So this is a very, very important parameter. Without this, you won't have your system set, you won't have a standardized way for your archive logs to, because the thing about it is this, so when you're recovering your database, you want to have the archive logs be in the same format, so you can just, you know, when you run this one command, it's going to ask you, okay, do you want to you have to recover this archive log. If they're not the same, then you find yourself in a whole lot of trouble. Archive log system so anytime you get this, you know, this is gonna be modified, you know, first of all, just make sure that you have, your text correct. Make sure it's not, you know, just, you know, messing with you or anything. So, what you need to get out of it, you need to issue a command or the system set. Log. All you have, so what do I need? Log underscore archive underscore guest underscore 2 equals ORCL 1, which is my primary database. So if you guys can remember, what I did is I'm gonna show you guys my init file at the end. I'm gonna compare the init file from primary database to the init file of my standby database. Basically, init file from my standby database, you know, that's one is the same as it would be for primary database. But it's that's two that's different, because that's two is gonna be you're gonna just be referring to I'm referring to the primary database in my dev 2, but the primary database in dev 2 is referring to the service, which is the second, which is the standby database. So I'm gonna issue equals location equals location valid for equals open. Underscore log file comma primary underscore row close paren db underscore unique underscore name equals orcl2 underscore dg single quotation rules f scope equals sp file system set, where did I go wrong? This system set, log of desk 2. Oh, I made a mistake. Location equals ORCL1. There you go. That's what I was missing. I was missing the I didn't make this parameter to to the primary database. And again, what I'm doing now is I'm just setting up a bi-directional situation where you have the primary database communicating with the standby database, and the standby database also interacting with the primary database. So it's going to be going back and forth. And the thing, what they each need to have the directory set up the right way, meaning that, you know, the environment they have to know the location from, you know, they have to know each other's location. So that's why archive log directory is so important, because this is gonna be the location that the primary database will be looking to drop or to deposit the archive logs that were created from the transactions. So after I've done that, I'm gonna issue these two very important commands. Auto system set log file underscore name underscore convert equals RCL1, RCL2, underscore DG, scope equals SP file. Again, this is just, I'm just making it easier for the two databases to interact. That's what the log files, and I'm going to show you one for the data files now. Auto system set, DB underscore file, underscore name, underscore comfort, equals RCL1. Or CR2 underscore DG close. So now I have it almost figured out, just almost. And one of the last parameters that I would say is, or maybe the last one, autism instead. So I have this is pretty much the last parameter that I need to set. What I'll do now is I will issue the command startup no mount walls. And while this is taking place, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna close this my standby init file. DG service started. So from the ORD command that I issued, it's already pretty much like what she should recommend is gonna start. There's nothing else that you need to do. Environment. I'll take this file. DB file name, principal program, convert, OCR, you know, you guys can stick it on it. So for these two parameters, I made a big mistake. So they should be, again, I should be referring to them as individual databases. So for this one, it should be OCL, single quote. Database is ready. It's actually, you know what? Startup. I'm gonna change it. I'm gonna change the auto database now. There you go. So this is the problem. So next, I have to put in my control files. So you have two ways here. You can do I think you should be able to do it auto system set control files. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna shut down my database, shut down immediate. And while it's shutting down, I'm gonna go to my SP file, delete it. I already have my P file open. So I will do this. What is it? I need to get location for my control file. So, archive log. No. I should leave this one open. What I'll do is admin. There you go. I can do this. So, I'll come to this one. I go to over there. Control files are. What I'll do is I will first of all open, you know what, I can just set it on my own, so it's going to be control underscore files equals interpretation open single quote. Paste it. So I have three of them. Control 01, 02, and 03. So let's make an issue. Control 01, SCTL. Close it. I'm going to copy this one. Copy. Paste. Control 02, TTL. Paste it. CTL, save it. I want to create SP file, one P file. There you go. I have myself a P file, NSP file now, so I'm going to issue command startup. Since I have my control files, that we should mount. There you go. whatever this is mounted. So what I need to do next is I need to I'm gonna close out this one. Let me just make sure before I move forward that everything is right. What? Okay, I think this is just about right. So what I'll do next is I need to if I issue a command alter database open now, it's not gonna be open. But first thing I need to do is I need to this is what I'll do. So I'll go to my backups. This is gonna be very, very important for you guys. You go to your diag or DBMS. I'm just gonna look at my my alert log. To see if the database is actually communicating. So this is what you guys are looking for. You're looking for the arc becoming a heartbeat arc. This is gonna be a very important. This is gonna basically tell you that, you know, that your database is ready to be, that your archive logs are ready to be transferred over from the primary database. So once you find it on the standby database alert log, you need to also check the alert log for the primary database, which is again diag RDBMS, your software name, and then go to trace, and then go to alert underscore log underscore your software name. And when you get to the bottom, heartbeat failed. Okay, so apparently the heartbeat is failing, so let's see what's going on. So I'm gonna come to this one. I'm gonna show you the TNS ping. I'm gonna issue this command, right? Recover? No. What command do I? It should be. Okay, guys, you guys should hold on. That's what I'm on. Okay. So what I'll do is I'll issue the command set log source, and then the log source is going to be the archive log location for my primary database, which is this one. Copy. Paste. that's not outsourced, and I'm gonna issue a command. Recover. Standby database. Until cancel. Using backup control. What you guys will see is that basically I have to bring my my standby database up to date. So I'm gonna have my archive log location open as I'm doing this. So it's looking for 24. I have 24, so what I'll issue, what I'll do is just issue, just press enter. Okay, look for 25, enter. After this is going to ask me for 33, right, which is something that I do not have. So what I'm going to do is when I get to 30, when it's going to get to, when it's going to ask me for 33, I'm going to issue the command cancel. Media recovery cancel. And what I'll do is, I'm going to start my the recovery process. So I'm going to issue the command. Recover manage standby database disconnect from session. When we started, that this is what you guys have to do. When you, so the thing is, I learned this from someone else. The reason why you get this error is actually because I still have my log source set for the primary database. So what you gotta do is host and then exit and then issue that same command again. Starting my recovery now. It's an error internally with SQL Plus, so I'm not gonna get into what's going on that one. And then media recovery is complete. And then what I'll do next is I will go to my my alert log files on my phone to see what's going on there. You have two ways of changing your archive log. You can issue the command switch the auto system switch log file for auto system archive log 10. So those are two ways to basically initiate an archive log with. So I'm really panicking now because my heartbeat is not coming on. So how operation is you still have standby database. So one of the things that I've done is I've already created a table on my family database, and what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna come to my standby database and I'm gonna basically see if I can see the data that's on my family database. It should be sent to me. Describe, select from table one. And if I can do that, then the standby was successful. Okay. Thanks a lot for watching. I'll see you guys next time.